Have you experienced Waswas or OCD while being on the toilet? No, it's not really about relieving yourself, but rather the cleansing ritual afterwards. In Arabic, it is called Istinja, and it basically means you pour water and wash your private parts after number one. As for number two, it is called Istijmar. Istijmar is valid whether one uses stones or tissue paper, even if water is available. There is no difference of opinion among the scholars on this point. The evidence lies in the report narrated by Al-Bukhari and Muslim from Abu Huraira, which says, "Whoever does wudu, let him rinse his nose, and whoever does istijmar, let him use an odd number." Oh, but that isn't the issue here. The issue is the doubts after this ritual. People who suffer from OCD oftentimes question themselves if they unintentionally passed urine. Join us in tackling the challenges, finding that balance between cleanliness and calm, and snagging some straightforward tips to breeze through moments of doubt. This one's for you, the Waswas warrior. Ready to dive in? Make sure you enable captions and subtitles. Washing after relieving oneself. The act of washing after relieving oneself is known as istinja. It involves cleaning the private parts after urinating to maintain ritual purity for acts of worship, such as prayer. Understanding and managing Waswas OCD in istinja. Pay attention to your feelings. First of all, it's important to recognize that the fears you're experiencing about istinja aren't real, but rather rooted in doubts. These feelings can be challenging, but it's okay to seek help and support. 1. Fear of urine drops. I totally get it. The fear of urine drops after cleaning is something many people go through. Islamic teachings emphasize cleanliness, but let's remember to be gentle with ourselves. Instead of rushing, try a more gradual approach. First, sit down or squat to empty your bladder. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam forbade us from urinating while standing due to the splashing back. If you still urinate standing, then it's no wonder you get OCD doubts about your cleanliness. So next time, just use a toilet sitting. Example: if you have finished urinating, wait a couple of seconds to make sure that you have completely emptied your bladder. Wash and try being reasonable with the amount of water, even if you feel overwhelmed with waswas. Not too much to waste water, and not too little as in to just sprinkle water. Sprinkling water is not enough for istinja. If you feel the urge to repeat washing, take a moment to pause. Maybe try reducing the time spent washing gradually, like decreasing it by 10 seconds each day. This small step might help in breaking the cycle. 2. Excessive washing and physical consequences. Excessive washing, especially with cold water, might be causing some discomfort. You waste water and might get a muscle spasm and irritation on the urethra due to the cold, which could make you feel you passed a drop of urine while you actually did not. Let's try using lukewarm water and being mindful of how long we spend washing to ensure it's comfortable for you. Taking care of yourself is essential, and you deserve that balance between cleanliness and well-being. Don't forget this is an easy ritual, and naturally it should not make you worry. Your waswas does not represent the reality. We do as we can, we are only human. 3. Fear of contamination. During number 2, I understand that dealing with hemorrhoids can make you worry about cleanliness after a bowel movement, but be aware of wasting too much time and water in the bathroom. It is a breeding ground for waswas, as well as opportunity for more hemorrhoids to grow. It's okay to find a middle ground, avoiding excessive washing and finding a reasonable cleaning process that eases your anxiety and perhaps save time and water. You might get anxious over the splashes of water. In some extreme cases, people complained about feeling the water from the toilet splash on their backs or shoulders. This is mere waswas, and the more time you spend thinking about it, the more somatic it becomes. Let's remember that the likelihood of water splashing back is minimal. 4. Smelling and checking for color. Smelling wet garments and checking for color is a common practice, but let's not let it become a source of constant checking. Scholars endorse these practices, but it's important not to let them contribute to obsessive thoughts. Example: limit yourself to checking once and then gradually decrease the frequency. Remember, these practices are meant to provide reassurance, not feed into obsessive thoughts. Remind yourself that drops on clothes might just be water from washing. Islamic teachings provide no basis for the belief that a urine drop can happen after completing the cleansing process. Practical steps for finding ease in istinja. 1. ERP method, exposure and response prevention. Taking small steps to face and resist the fears associated with istinja can be empowering. Recognize that these fears aren't real but products of waswas. Example: if you usually feel compelled to check for impurities multiple times, try resisting the urge to check one time. Later on, give up the habit of checking and brush the idea off. The point is to gradually decrease the frequency to build resilience against the fear. 2. Medical evaluation. Considering a medical checkup with a doctor can help rule out any physical concerns like urinary incontinence. It's a step towards taking care of your well-being. Example, share your concerns with a healthcare professional who can guide you through a proper medical assessment. Knowing that there are no underlying health issues can provide a sense of reassurance. 3. Kegel exercises. Exploring Kegel exercises for better bladder control could be a helpful addition to your routine. Sometimes, small physical changes can contribute to our overall well-being. Example, start with basic Kegel exercises by contracting and relaxing your pelvic floor muscles. A simple routine of 10 contractions, holding each for 5 seconds, can be a good beginning. 4. Mindfulness techniques. Mindfulness and relaxation techniques are great tools for managing anxiety. Remember, these fears aren't real, but negative thoughts and shaitan can make them feel overwhelming. You're not alone, and seeking help is a courageous step toward healing. Example, practice deep breathing exercises. Inhale slowly, hold for a few seconds, and exhale. This simple technique can help you stay present and reduce anxiety associated with these fears. Remember, we're all on this journey together. Your feelings are valid, and it's okay to seek support and take small steps toward finding an escape from waswas. You're not alone in this, and there's a whole community here to support you. It is essential not to give in to your OCD. Try gradually ignoring the intrusive thoughts about bladder and just transfer your mind into the period when you did not suffer from this issue. This is a grounding technique mixed with visual therapy. If you consistently remind yourself that these thoughts are not real, soon you will be free of them. Because the brain creates new paths of assurance and kicks the fear paths off. Please remember that some scholars insist on the idea that after Istijmar, if you find your clothes soiled with a tiny impurity, it is negligible. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to reach out for help in the comments.